Looks like I'm not getting in. Find a cure. This poison is killing me. Oh, I have been poisoned. Superb!
You there. Please, I beseech you, let me out of this cell.
That one cell is a broken door, but I saw someone inside. Another secret switch, perhaps.
Bless you. Just pull that iron ring there. That'll open the door.
I'm free. Laken be praised. Thank the divine.
Of course.
I'll tell you a little secret.
The cell across the left is special. They use it as a hidden storage place, you see.
I don't know what the trick is. But there must be a way to get past the back wall. No problem.
Another one to add to the collection. Yeah. Shiny. Shiny? What nonsense. Yeah. Another one to add to the collection. Shiny. Thank you.
Are you fucking serious?
Of all the scenarios, I really thought blasting our way in would have been the least likely one.
We are in. Good work, Dragon Knight. It wasn't very subtle, but good work nonetheless.
I wonder if Earl King still keeps his writings around. There was some interesting magic to be found in them.
Not about the tower itself, no, but plenty about Lycan.
Did you ever wonder how Lycan is able to live such an unnaturally long life? It is because he has been soul-forged with an immortal demon. This spell ties their souls together and ensures Lycan dies only when the ever-living demon does. But the reverse is also true. So if we can summon the demon and defeat it, Lycan will fall dead without ever having known what hit him. I assure you it is not. Why take the chance? If you have really faced demons before and lived, you can surely face another one. There is but one small snag. To be able to summon a particular demon, you need to know its name. The only one present at the Soulforge ritual was Earl King, Lycan's goblin lackey. Unfortunately, Lycan cut his vocal cords to prevent his telling anyone the demon's name. See if you can find clues that may reveal it. Once we have the name,
looks like I'm not getting in.
There's no other way to go. Oh, a visitor. And clean. Look at this place. It's a mess.
To be home again. I don't think it will ever happen.
Does it? Well, never heard about it? No. This is Lycan's morgue, and I'm the undertaker. Ah, you seek to overthrow him, then. That's good. He's a nasty old brute. Tell you what. Once my dear master has been dealt with, I'll move up to the necromancer platform, yes? I offer many exclusive limbs that will be very useful if you should perform the dark arts. It's just a little enterprise on the side that, yes, necromancers love to create all kinds of bizarre creatures. But often it's a nuisance to hunt for the parts you need. That's where I step in. About 20 years, I should say, I was dragged in by thugs when our ship crashed on the island. Lycan spared me because of my knowledge of anatomy and embalming. But I haven't seen the sky since. My father was an undertaker, and his father before him. And my mother was a surgeon, and her mother before her. They performed their jobs like no other. But having a surgery and mortuary under the same roof didn't exactly improve their reputation. I can't remember the name of the boat, nor who was on it, really. I admit I was a stowaway trying to evade some debts. The one thing I do recall vividly is the incident itself. We were out on the sea, nothing but water in sight, and the next thing we knew, we were stuck in a huge tree. My arms are still blue from the pinches I gave myself, but sadly, I wasn't dreaming. You do that. Defeating Lycan won't be easy, but I wish you good luck. Hello again. You do that.
I was hoping he'd let me sell stuff. But I guess not.
goblin stares at you without fear, anger, or any other emotion, his whole countenance gives testimony of complete indifference.
I think I'll read some more of Ghost's Balance tonight.
A quick guttural growl escapes from Earl King's throat. You interpret it as no. The goblin stares at you without fear, anger, or any other emotion. His whole countenance, an angry hiss, confirms your suspicion. Earl King would indeed consider.
Shiny.
Which book would you like to peruse? A cheap parody. Which book would you like disturbing? Highly disturbing. Which book would you like to peruse? Look at that centerfold. Which book would you like to peruse? Judging by the underlined passages, someone is extremely familiar with the urinary tract. Which book would you like to peruse? Quoth the parrot, nevermore. Which book would you like to peruse? You hear a click inside the wall.
Another one to add to the collection. Shiny. Another one to add to the collection. Shiny.
Written in thick streaks of blood. Amidst bizarre occult signs is the demon's name, Razakal.
Halt a moment, Dragon Knight, and let me warn you. Damien's presence in Broken Valley is growing darker every hour. Conquering the Battle Tower will provoke his supreme wrath here and in the Vale. So if you have unfinished business there, wrap it up before you front Lycan.
The name. Do you have it? Well done! Now we're getting somewhere. Come on. The summoning circle is not far away. You are starting to vex me, servant of the serpent. If I can't stop them, Razakal will. And Master will piece me together once more. Your tongue is still sharp as always. Maybe I'll slash it from your skull and use it as a replacement for my own.
Enough talk! You abhorrent imitation! It's your turn to spend some time underground.
So, my warm-blooded counterpart joins the scuffle. Splendid! Those legs of yours were always better than the ones you gave me. As of now, your limbs are on sale, and I'm going shopping.
Is mine.
All right, but don't tarry too long. Lycan might discover us. Are you ready to face the demon? Excellent. I summon thee from your hellish dimension, friend of Lycan and forged of soul. From the torrid abyss, I summon thee, Razakal!
Why did you summon me from Tartarus, you know? What is this you are? Now that I'm in revolution field, I'll teach you what happens when you borrow a demon's warhammer and not return it.
Aha! I see Lycan made new friends. A smart plan to bypass him by fighting me. Though I'm not sure why you think that little stratagem has made your life any easier.
Was it
Oh, may 10,000 plagues find that coward of a demon. Now we have no choice but to face Lycan. This will not be an easy battle, but I do have a few tricks up my sleeve. What would you like me to do? It shall be done. Now let's go.
So, we meet again. The usurper and my erstwhile slave come to claim my battle tower. Thus, I kill them. Ah, yes. Kill them. And then I get it from the chest. And then it can begin. Now had time to reflect upon you and the situation you place me in. I realized it was but a matter of time before you'd arrive. You probably suffer from the delusion this tower is yours by right, do you not? An absurd suggestion. I have been its undisputed ruler for hundreds of years. Between the moment I spilled the blood of Sassan here, and the racking, killing, and defiling of those newlyweds this morning, countless necromantic excesses have passed the eons unchallenged. You are enticed then by the unique delights she promises. Your mind reeled at the possibilities, the fantasies. The actions of an ignoramus. A vandal, a destroyer of art! And it is this mongrel that wants my battle tower. How utterly contemptible! But enough of this chit-chat. Summoning Razakel was a nice enough idea while it lasted, but you have come here to fail, my friend. All I can offer you now is an eternal life by my side. Another undead puppet to be subjected to my every twisted whim.
The necromancer is no more, but a greater evil still eyes your tower, like a snake ready to strike.
So, the dragon is about to hatch with the aid of the elusive Xandalor. I should have known you'd still crawl out of the woodwork, old goat.
Hold your tongue, villain! How dare the scourge of Rivalon show his face here? You shall pay yet for the atrocities you committed!
Ha! You are up there in your ivory tower of moral absolutes. And still you lose perspective. The Divine's death, the war. It was he who caused it by murdering my beloved.
Lucien did the right thing. Igerna worked for the Black Ring, and therefore she had to die. He would have done it again if need be, and so would I.
Kerr, I loved her, and you butchered her. Now, for every drop of her blood you spilled, oceans of man's will flow, starting with that of your new pet here. My armadas will see to that.
He is launching an attack on your tower. Go on now, become the dragon, and show him your might.
This will help.
Hurry now, and find the dragon stone to unleash the powers I gave you.
Shiny.
Hurry, and become the dragon.
We are under attack! Quickly! The Dragonstone lies beyond that door.
You are a dragon now. Show that cursed lot the might of the ancient race. Burn their flesh and topple their towers. These flying fortresses form the most extraordinary of challenges. They are built in different forms and for various functions, which you'll learn to recognize. That was a ballista. They aren't too powerful, but be wary of them, as they often come in great numbers. Good riddance. That nest tower would have kept on throwing enemy after enemy at you. Handle the Damned One's forces. Come, let us return to your tower.
You have shown Damien the dominion of the dragon, and now I have need of it too. I have the shield we need to enter the Hall of Echoes, but things have gone awry. Meet me in Alaroth's Great Hall, where I shall need you to help me stem the tides of evil that were released in search of the shield. The city has been overrun, and Dawn shall find but a blackened ruin if you do not come. I need you, Dragon Knight.
I am following you, Dragon Knight, but I'd like to introduce people to you. Thank you, Dragon Knight. These men served Lycan, not by their own will, but by intimidation, and now they will serve you. Tom, Dick, and Harry are veteran trackers who will search the lands for the enchantments, gems, and ingredients you desire. I should mention, though, that Lycan equipped them as poorly as he treated them. But you can change that. Your trainer can provide them with weapons, which will increase their combat effectiveness and reduce the time it takes to complete a mission. Your enchanter can forge them armors, which will heighten their chance of success and decrease their chance of being. Should they be hurt during their travels, you'll need to inform your alchemist so he may heal them. That's it. May they bring you great treasure.
Brave Xandalor. He has the shield already. Do not dismiss his call for aid, Dragon.
Any gem you want, I'll get it. I am at your command.
Sometimes I just often stay away. Then again, I'd better not mess with a dragon knight.
Certainly.
Inns dragon knight, what enchantment would you like me to search for?
How come Sasson got pretty again all of a sudden? I will be here if you need me.
No land too far, no sea too wide. I'll find each and every ingredient you desire.
That alchemist says it easy. We do the dangerous gathering, and he just boils our spoils in a kettle.
In these clothes? But I'll not survive. I'll do it, Dragon Knight.
My Dragon Master, let me bid you a fond welcome. I am Kirill, the famous composer. What would you like me to play for you?
I'll write a requiem for Lycan, which will probably be the most cheerful piece I have ever written.
Like many, I was caught in Lycan's evil web. Luckily, the old pervert had a weakness for music and dance. That is why I am still alive and composing. And Salome, alive and dancing. Something frivolous? No problem.
Hail, Dragon Knight! How may I please you? Whose head shall I ask this one for? Maybe, yes. I never could stand the man. As you wish.
These are your personal quarters, where you may stash the treasure you find and teleport to the places you have traveled to. Now that this island lies covered and surrounded by Damien's toxic air, this portal is our only way out.
I bid you welcome, Dragon Knight.
I am Hermaphroditus, your illusionist.
How can I assist you? Why be satisfied with the pleasures of one when you can have those of the both of them? Of course.
Max. Master Chamber. The spell we seek must be near. The visibility spell. We have found it. And Lycan, that fool, never even took notice of what can reveal the Hall of Echoes.
How can I help you, my leech? Of course. Which an alchemist distills the pure potency of the plants and herbs to create an up. Recipes from obscure books are also always a valuable commodity to any alchemist worth his or her salt. So should you find these during your journeys, I would advise you to bring them to the tower. Would you like to know more about somebody else? Very well. See you later.
This is an impressive location, to be sure. Ready to get busy? Sure, what did you have in mind? Such as? Good idea. For a few gold pieces, I can provide him with a great beginner's weapon. Immediately, my... Dragon. Back for more? I'm ready for another.
Sure, what did you have in mind?
Such as?
Good idea. For a few gold.
Immediately, my. Back for more? I'm ready for another.
Sure, what did you have in mind?
Such as?
Good idea.
For immediately, my. Back for more? I'm ready.
Sure, what did you have in mind?
Such as?
That'll cost you a pretty penny, I'm afraid. Though they'll operate the better for
immediately, my dragon.
back for more? I'm ready for another round if you are. Sure, what did you have in mind? Such as?
That'll cost you a pretty penny.
Immediately, my... Back for more? I'm ready for another round.
Sure, what did you have in...
Such as?
That'll cost you a pretty penny.
Immediately, my... Back for more? I'm ready for another round if you are.
Great. I was apprehensive at first. But now I've come to realize what a great opportunity this is.
To have such powers at my disposal, to work for a Dragon Knight who opposes the Black Ring against all odds. One thing bothers me, though. A matter of unfinished business, if you like. There is a man, Morgan's his name, who is very much enamored with me and gave me my necklace. Though he always loved me more than I loved him, I feel it would be cruel of me to simply keep him in the dark about my whereabouts. I'd be very much obliged if you'd return the necklace to him and let him know he must move on. He won't be too difficult to find, as he is the harbour master in the Orebus Fjords. It's not a pleasant thing to do, but my mind is made up. My place is here now, with you. Let's get it on. Back for more? I'm ready for another round if you are. I'll be waiting for you.
It's dead. Well done, Dragon Knight. I hope my dear brother and I will be reunited someday. Such stories I could tell. That I can...
gotta read. Well, open them. This way I can... if they do anything special.
This book contains research notes on necromancy, jotted down by Lycan himself.
It is highly interesting to note that healthy subjects exposed to intense physical pain still reflect that anguish after the transformation into an undead entity. When the forearms are removed, for instance, and replaced by blades, an intense process of sawing, jamming, and stitching, I find that subjects who undergo this procedure alive and conscious make for fiercer and more merciless undead warriors. Needless to say, it is a process I shall regularly practice, perhaps even exclusively, should other experiments secure the same rate of success.
This little volume is called Amusing Anomalies and contains anecdotes about the lighter side of necromancy.
In a frivolous mood, I revived a corpse too decomposed to be of any real use. The thing staggered round a bit as it tried to speak with a rotten tongue, whilst its glib eyes fell from their sockets and flesh dropped in meaty splotches, all to a highly comical effect. Encouraged by this jocular escapade, I revived my disciples, a fresh young man, but not before having carefully removed every piece of bone from his body, save for the skull. The sight of the helplessly quivering heap of meat, combined with a look of utter panic and horror on the callow face, proved to put too great a strain on the simulated seriousness of the assembled onlookers, and all laughed uncontrollably.
Good to see you. I'll say. Though the atmosphere is... similar. Weird chap you've got up here, by the way. Knows his stuff, though. It's just that he keeps shouting out, blood and death. I sleep here, you know.
Death! and twisted life thereafter. We'll slash and... so it...
and I let the blood...
we'll slash and sew it...
And I let the blood flow, Master.
All I need for a good creature, not for an ultimate one. Yes. Yes, there is such a beast. But bring me the limbs, for I will have need of them. A deep cave in the Orobas Fjords houses the creature, it is rumored. Find it. Show it steel and piercing pain. Then I'll maim and...
Shiny.
Welcome to the Greek. Last time I checked, they were hale and hearty enough. No need to spoil them. I have all I need, but we are close here to the Orobas Fjords, are we not? I have heard rumors of an alchemist who lives there in a cave in the mountains. His spellbook can... Oh, so I have heard. So maybe you could borrow it? Splendid!
It's sure here, isn't it? Not very good for the lungs.
Then I'll make sure they get it.
What would you like me to...
You'll have it for no more.
Right away.
Esteemed Dragon Knight.
Then I'll make sure...
What would you like me to...
You'll have it for no more than a hand...
Right away.
What would you like...
You'll have it for no more than...
Right away.
Esteemed Dragon Knight.
What can I do?
This is the best enchantment smithy I've ever seen. But now that you mention it, there are specific supplies that could improve it even more. My assistant, Lister,
was on his way back from Broken Valley to the harbor in Oribus Fjords when I was spirited away by the island. He was transporting a shipment of goods I bought from Dirk, a smith in the valley, which I could use to create some unique enchantments. Maybe you could verify his safe arrival in the fjords and bring me the shipment.
If you have the desire to do so, great Dragon Knight.
Of course, that goes without saying. Right away.
See where that takes me. Yeah, my mean buns. I'm trying to drive
Ah, good to see you again. How goes the ascent to Ulfmar? I'd be the hero of the Seahorse.
Forget, Dragonite, that you may use the stone to instantly travel to your battle tower.
Shiny. I cannot take my dragon form here. No good. I'll have to walk. No good. I'll have to walk.
Hello there. I'm Crab, Mine Prospector.
Crab's mind is filled with facts and figures about all kinds of stones and ores, but red ore specifically. No doubt from now on, you'll be able to find this precious commodity more quickly and easily.
Oh, yes. The Orobas Fjords are filled with riches.
if you know where to dig. It's no wonder the Dragon Knight Orobas was so rich. All the mines belonged to him. Now, mining has become rarer because of the abundance of goblins and wyverns. The most prominent active quarry is in High Hall, a mountain hamlet about an hour's walk away. By prospecting, of course. I was sent to check if a mine that was closed after some accidents 2 years ago might still be viable for excavation. I'd barely entered the place when the spear of an imp tried to carve me a third nostril. Perhaps you could get rid of that vermin. You sure look capable enough. They'll have a leader, so chop off its head, and the rest will be... If you look out to sea from here, it's just around that headland. I don't have a boat, however, so it might be a bit of a problem to get there. Be safe now.
Shiny.
Yeah. made it! Oh, boy, how scared I was! Oh, you...
Luckiest laundry day. Yes, yes, of course. I'm still a bit nervous, though.
Hey.
Listen, take this, yes? Least I can do. Least I can do.
Phew! I'm off, then. Thank you, Slayer.
Why shouldn't I keep it? It brings out my eyes.
Your eyes are pretty enough without that ring on your finger. It's just not proper.
A body washed up on the beach and I took this beautiful ring from it. I mean, I'm sorry the poor man's dead and all that, but it's not like he has any use for it anymore.
Karen, how can you be so uncaring? We must find out who this man is and return the ring to his family. Well spoken, Slayer. Come, Karen. We have some detective work to do.
Oh, I guess it's the proper thing to do. Pity, though. How it sparkles.
You big goody-goody, you.
Feel my wrath.
There is a presence among these cliffs, the waterfall.
Damn it.
good. I'll have to walk.
Oh, what the fuck? I'm gonna kill a couple of those skeleton things first before I go. Time to go, because fuck this. Michael, go.
No good. I'll have to walk.
Sentinel View written on it. Its destination is Camp Eagle's Nest. The control panel is being destroyed.
We have here.
Why? It is the Dragon Knight, my dear. Ensnared by the Black Ring and unable to shapeshift into its fire-spewing self.
How kind the serpent is, my sweet, to so openly walk in trap, almost like it wants to be slaughtered.
Quite considerate indeed, my darling. Which is why I would suggest we return the courtesy.
You're always the gentleman, my cherished, and I quite agree. Come, let us see what music it makes when we pierce its flesh.
Then we'll drink its blood by the fire, my make jubilant love.
Yeah. This will help. Shiny. The door won't open.
No, halt! You win, dragon. We surrender.
What? No, we won't, you rotten coward!
The dragon just killed Lord John and Lady Kara. You really think we can take it down?
Yeah. We surrender. And we'll trade with you. I have unique magics to offer.
And I the best the ring smiths can fashion. Have a deal, dragon.
May it be the damn.
Is it trading you're after? As long as the dragon doesn't find the girl, we can still have her later. Ah, tricks, dirty mind tricks. She's a champion. The only one we didn't kill because she's pretty. Lord John and Lady Kara, they like 'em pretty. I could tell you what they planned for her, but I don't want you to retch all over me. Behind the door, downstairs. But the key, that I threw out of the window. We were sent because of you. Sent to slay the serpent. Damien the Great chose the king and queen of Poenari Castle. The mighty couple to have the honor of your blood. But he did not expect you to be so strong, and neither did Lord John and Lady Kara, united now in death. If I must... Yes? What? Forever?
Dragon, demon, it's all the same to me. As soon as it turns its back on me, I'll slit its throat. No! No, no! It was but a joke, a stupid thought. Don't get mad, dragon.
Good.
Another one to add to the collection. Victory is mine.
You! Listen, I haven't much time. The goblins, they stole my goods and cut out my gut, leaving me to die slowly. Kill them. Kill their beholder leader. I revenge!
Yes!
die.
Another one to add to the collection.
Superb!
Motherfucker.
I won't do this tomorrow. My head hurts too much for this. I will see you next time. Or maybe tomorrow. The game's running better than it was.